Let us find the derivative of y with respect to x if x and y are determined by the relationship x plus the square root of x times the square root of y is equal to y squared. You'll notice that in this relationship, we don't have something of the form y equals f of x. That is, y is not explicitly solved for in this relationship, which is okay, right? We can compute the derivative using implicit differentiation, which is what we're going to demonstrate here in this video. Try to solve for y, assuming that's even algebraically possible, because sometimes you do get problems with that. It's a chore that is not really necessary. We can actually derive dy over dx completely implicitly here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the derivative with respect to x on both sides of the equations. We're going to take the derivative of the left-hand side, and we're going to do this on the right-hand side as well, for which on the left-hand side, we have to take the derivative of x plus the square root of x times the square root of y. I'm going to put a little prime notation here as just shorthand for the derivative with respect to x. Keep that in mind here. As we do have the two variables, it's important we remember we're taking the derivative with respect to x. And then we have to take the derivative of the right-hand side as well. So we're going to take the derivative of y squared with respect to x. Now, on the left-hand side, because we have a sum of two terms, we have an x and the square root of x times the square root of y, by derivative laws, we can take their derivatives separately. So we're going to get an x prime plus the derivative of the square root of x times the square root of y, like so. On the right-hand side, this is where the chain rule comes out, which is really the basis behind implicit differentiation. We want to recognize that we're taking the derivative with respect to x, but we don't have an x there, we have a y. So when we take the derivative with respect to x of this y squared, we can use the chain rule and be like, I could do the following. I could take the derivative of y squared with respect to y, and then times that by the derivative of y with respect to x. For which, if you take the derivative of y squared with respect to y by the power rule, you'll get a 2y. And then when you take the derivative of y with respect to x, well, that's just the y prime we're searching for right now. So we end up with just this y prime on the right-hand side. Continuing on, when we look at the left-hand side again, remember, when you see this x prime, the prime is just short for the derivative with respect to x. So this is just dx over dx, which is equal to 1. So we can make that simplification right here. We get 1 plus. Well, now we have to take the derivative of the square root of x times the square root of y. Because we have a product of two functions, we should take the derivative using the product rule, for which we'll get the square root of x prime times the square root of y. And then we add to that the square root of x times the square root of y prime. We have to take those derivatives in just a second. And then on the right-hand side, we still have this 2y prime. Not much to do there. So now we have to take the derivative of the square root of x. So remember, when you're taking the derivative of the square root, say, of u with respect to x, the idea here is to think of it as a power function. So we have u to the 1/2 power. And so by the usual power rule, you're going to get 1/2 u to the negative 1/2 power times the derivative of u, that is the derivative of u with respect to x, for which you could rewrite that, and this is how we're going to do it here. You're going to end up with a u prime over 2 times the square root of u. So that's the derivative of square root function using the chain rule. So when we apply that here, we're going to get 1 plus the square root of x's derivative becomes, well, you get a 2 times the square root of x in the denominator. You also have to get the derivative of x on the top, but like we observed earlier, that's just a 1, right? So I can actually get away with just putting a 1 right there. We times that by the square root of y. And then on the next one, we have the square root of x. We have to multiply this by the derivative of the square root of y, which, as we observe from this formula right here, we end up with a y prime over 2 times the square root of y in that fashion. This is still equal to 2y prime. So now that we've done this, we've calculated all the derivatives, we now want to solve for y prime, because that was our goal, remember, looking at the top of this screen. Our goal was to find dy over dx. Y prime is just an abbreviation of that. So looking at the current equation, what y primes do we have? We have a y prime right here. We have a y prime right here. So we want to combine the y primes together, and then we can solve for the y prime. So what I'm going to do is move this expression to the right-hand side, and we can do that by subtracting both sides of the equation there. So on the left-hand side, we'll be left with a 1 times the square root of y over 2 times the square root of x. On the right-hand side, we have a 2y prime, and then we're going to get subtraction here minus the square root of x y prime over 2 times the square root of y, like so. And so now notice the right-hand side, everyone has a factor of y prime. We're going to factor it out. That was the whole point of moving it there. so that the right-hand side is now going to look like 2y minus the square root of x over 2 times the square root of y. And you multiply that by y prime. So that's the right-hand side. So then to solve for y prime, we're going to divide both sides by the coefficient of y prime, which looks like 2y minus the square root of x over 2 times the square root of y. We have to do it to the other side as well. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. We have to treat them the same. And so then solving for y prime, we end up with y prime is equal to what looks like a mess of numbers right now. We get 1 plus the square root of y over 2 times the square root of x all over 2y minus the square root of x over 2 times the square root of y, which technically speaking, this is the derivative. We've now solved for y prime here, but like I said, it's quite messy. This isn't a very practical form for the derivative. Notice we have these fractions inside of fractions. Let's try to clean that up a little bit. Let's notice what we have here. We have a 2 times the square root of x, and we have a 2 times the square root of y. If we identify the least common denominator of these baby fractions there, you'll end up with a 2 times the square root of x times the square root of y. So what I want to do is multiply the top of the main denominator by 2 root x root y, and then we want to do that to the denominator as well so things stay proportional. You'll notice, of course, that this right here in red is just the number 1, written strategically here to kind of help us clean up these fractions. So when we distribute this across the top and the bottom, this will clean up our fractions a lot. We're going to end up with a 2 times the square root of x times the square root of y. When you multiply it on the fraction next, the 2 and the square root of x will cancel out. And so then you're going to get a square root of y times the square root of y, which that simplifies just to be a y. Like so. We're going to see something very similar in the denominator. We're going to get a 2 times 2, which is a 4. You have a y. The square root of x times the square root of y. Just leave that alone. I mean, if you want to combine the y's together, you can get y to the 3/2 power. I'm just going to leave it as y times the square root of y. I think that's perfectly simple for us right here. And then when you multiply, when you distribute this onto the second fraction right here, again, where the 2's will cancel, the square root of y's will cancel, and then we'll end up with a minus the square root of x times the square root of x, which we saw above. That product should just be an x. The square root should disappear. So now we've cleaned up the fractions. And so we see that dy over dx is equal to this thing right here. We could continue forward if we wanted to say like rationalize a numerator denominator, but I don't really see any algebraic benefit of doing that at this moment. Nothing simplified, I would say, happens from rationalizing. So we're going to leave it in this format and report this as the derivative of y with respect to x, which we computed using implicit differentiation.